Good morning, everyone. I am Anant Jamaria, Advocate, Delhi High Court. I'll be presenting to you today what is net neutrality and various aspects related to net neutrality. Net neutrality is the fundamental dogma of open internet. Both government and ISP should treat all data on internet neutrally or equally without discriminating. Differential pricing for user, content, website, application, etc. should be avoided in order to keep a open access and open internet as such. Tim Wu in 2003 for the first time wrote about network neutrality. His paper was titled Net Neutrality, Broadband Discrimination. He stated out broadly what is net neutrality and how does the net neutrality principle affect the open internet as such. The first principle of the open internet is internet neutrality. That is, network neutrality is the principle that all internet traffic should be treated equally, and internet traffic includes all of the different messages, files, data sent over the internet, including, for example, email, digital, audio files, etc. According to the Columbia professor, the best way to explain network neutrality is that a public information network will end up being most useful if all content, website and platform will be treated equally. Let us understand with the help of an example that, for example, that there are something called as dumb pipes. Dumb pipes is essentially where there is no usage of the pipes, such as water pipes, that supply water to our homes. We do not have any access to what happens in the pipes as such. But what happens essentially is that the source from which the water goes and the way we receive water, there is no tampering with it. That is the concept of net neutrality, that the internet should be like dumb pipes where you cannot have access to any particular method or means, but only the consumer and the provider can essentially get the right to do so. When we come to the open internet, the idea of open internet is that the full resources of the internet and means to operate it should be easily accessible to individuals, companies and organizations. This often includes ideas such as net neutrality, open standards, transparency and lack of internet censorship. When we come to proponent of net neutrality, they see this as an important component of open internet, where policies such as equal treatment of data and open with standards allow them using the internet to equally communicate and openly communicate with conduct businesses and activities without interference from a third party. A closed internet is clearly in violation to the open access to all and open internet. So, the next concept we come down to is the various issues that are pertaining to net neutrality. The first one we will discuss is blocking. First issue is blocking, which is the consumer being the ultimate benefactor of the services, they shall be unfettered and unhindered. The primary concern to the same is between the legal and illegal content. The ISP has complete right to block all illegal content of the internet service provided by them. Legal content, on the other hand, however, shall not be discriminated, and no commercial entity should have the right to tamper with the access to such information. Throttling. Throttling is the procedure by which the ISP defines two broad issues, that is, the internet service provided by them. Second, the two lanes, that is the fast lane and slow lane. The fast lane is where by the content is throttled and the user is able to experience the said content at a quicker speed and time. There are usually agreements between ISPs and such content providers. So, for example, if you are able to access certain services such as Chromecast or Netflix at a quicker speed, that means your internet service provider is somewhere throttling. Second of all, the slow lane, however, is whereby the speed of internet in order to access the content is slowed down in order to grant preference to the fast lane. So, now example that, for example, you are accessing Voot or, for example, Hotstar. The speed becomes equally slow when we come to such particular things. Because why? Because they are in slow lane. So, the fast lanes are given preference because they are into agreements with the party to provide commercially, and slow lanes are ones which effectively get affected. So, throttling is bad. Why? Because everyone should have the equal access to the speed and to the content. Now, the third principle is accountability and transparency. The concept of accountability and transparency is inherited in any commercial undertaking and providing of services. The ISPs have a discrete and hidden dealing with commercial entities and content providers which strongly oppose net neutrality. The ISPs should be transparent enough as to provide the consumers of internet service of the true accountability as to dealing with other such entities, and the ISP is not violating any such principle of net neutrality. Chromecast, an ISP in the United States of America, was caught throttling the speed of access of certain content providers and did the fraud and faced action by the FCC. Fourth, what prioritization? The net neutrality is prioritization and often referred to as the preference treatment. The particular method is referred to throttling and thereby provide the priority to content providers who pay for internet service providers over any other content provider who is not paying for such prioritization. This essentially makes internet a field whereby it pays the most to the largest viewer base and consumers thereby. So, essentially the preference treatment is given to you with only if you pay a certain amount.